Presidential debate with me.
Want to watch the presidential debate?
Yeah, I'm gonna share my screen.
Okay. We gotta say, every time somebody gets cooked.
Yeah.
It's just ridiculous.
Sleepy Joe's talking, so we just talking. We gotta like.
Thank you.
There
have been many young women murdered by the same people he allows to come across our border. We have a border that's the most dangerous place anywhere in the world. Consider the most dangerous place anywhere in the world. And he opened it up, and these killers are coming
in. Bro, chill, he locked in, bro.
And they are raping and killing women.
Talk about your people. Talk about your people.
As far as the abortion's concerned, it is now
back with the states. You're talking about Central Asians.
In many cases,
what are you talking about?
It's frankly a very liberal decision. In many cases, it's
who are we talking about there?
But they're voting, and it's bringing it back to the vote of the people, which is what everybody wanted,
not my people.
Including the founders, if they knew about this issue, which, frankly, they didn't. But they would have. Everybody wanted brought back. Ronald Reagan wanted it brought back. He wasn't able to get it. Everybody wanted it brought back, and many presidents had tried to get it back. I was the one to do it. And again, this gives it the vote of the people, and that's where they wanted
it.
Every legal scholar wanted it that way.
Staying on the topic of abortion, President Biden, seven states, I'll let you do that. This is the same topic. Seven states.
Both these niggas low-key have helped me out.
Legal restrictions on how far into a pregnancy a woman can obtain an abortion.
Biden nigga helped me help my family with their student loans, and a Trump nigga helped my peoples with their COVID loans.
She had three trimesters. First time is between the woman
with them stimmies.
Second time is between the doctor and an extreme situation. A third time is between the doctor, between the woman and the state.
But the PPPs.
That the politicians, the founders wanted the politicians to be the ones making decisions about woman's health is ridiculous. That's the last. No politician should be making that decision. A doctor should be making that decision.
Simi ain't do shit.
That's how it should be run.
My homeboys are broke. Ain't do shit for me. I ain't get shit.
I'm going to restore Roe v. Wade.
So that means he can take the life of the baby in the ninth month. And even after birth, because some states, Democrat run, take it after birth.
That's
again,
tough.
The governor, former governor of Virginia.
I ain't gonna lie, after birth is crazy.
What to do with
after birth is crazy.
He's willing to,
ninth month is crazy. I go
the baby out of the womb in the ninth month and kill the baby.
But I'm for abortion, I ain't gonna lie. But ninth month is crazy. I'll say like 3 months, tight shit, a month, 2 months, some shit.
Roe v. Wade does not provide for that.
After, when it's actually like 4 minutes or some shit? That's crazy. I can't do it.
That's the only circumstance in which that can happen. But we are not for late-term abortion, period. Period, period.
Yeah, do late-term abortions, are they even often?
You can do whatever you want, depending on the state. You can do whatever you
how
want.
How often are those?
We don't think that's a good thing. We think
like
it's a radical
a week
thing.
Of finding out
we
if,
think the Democrats if, are
yeah,
radicals,
they
not the
to
Republicans.
Have an
bro, they're not common at all.
51 years, Constitutional Scholarship said it was the right way to go.
Nigga, my chance to kill those babies.
And it was taken away because this guy put very conservative members on the Supreme Court. He takes credit for taking it away. What's he going to do? What's he going to do, in fact, if the MAGA Republicans, he gets elected.
You know what's crazy? What I realize with these presidents?
And they pass a universal ban.
Whoever's president at the time, when it's time for the next nigga, like the young niggas, like my chat and the other, they're just tired of him. Like, yo, this nigga didn't do shit. Get the next nigga in here. Like, I remember Trump was president, and towards the end of the term, everybody literally vote. All my chat, everybody wanted this Biden nigga to win. Now that Biden's president, they don't want this nigga to win no more.
Have illegally crossed the southern border under watch.
He almost took us to war.
Overwhelming states and overwhelming cities such as New York and
you know
Chicago,
what's crazy,
and
does?
In some cases, causing real
you're
safety
about to be
and
too old to get dressed.
Concerns.
I know.
Given
so
that, why should voters trust you to solve this crisis?
Either one of these laws is going
to
take us to war, bro.
Bipartisan agreement that not only changed all of that, made sure
yo,
that
y'all are fucked. I forgot.
You had no circumstance where they could come across.
But that's been a thing, though. We know that, right?
The border police there are now.
Mm-hmm. That's not new.
A significantly increased the number of asylum officers.
Of course.
By the way, the Border Patrol endorsed
but
me.
But didn't Russia declare
endorsed
war on
my
us?
Position. In addition to that, we found
that
ourselves in a situation where when he was president, he was separating babies from their mothers, putting them in cages, making sure they were the families were separated. That's not the right way to go. What I've done since I've changed the law, what's happened? I've changed it in a way that now you're in a situation where
they said they don't fuck with us. 40%
fewer people
who don't fuck with us
coming across the border illegally.
Russia.
It's better than when he left office. And I'm going to continue to move until we get the total ban. on the total initiative.
Oh no, they're gonna make memes on this nigga. Oh my god, they can just stutter. More
asylum officers.
Yo, this, I hate the way this nigga talk.
I don't know what he said at the end of that sentence.
Oh my god, he go with the memes. Oh my god.
We had the safest border in the history of our country.
Oh my god, bro, he went with the
all
memes.
All he had to do was leave it. All he had to do was leave it. He decided to open up our border, open up our country to people that are from prisons, people that are from mental institutions, insane asylum, terrorists. We have the largest number of terrorists coming into our country right now. All terrorists, all over the world, not just in South America, all over the world. They come from the Middle East, everywhere. All over the world, they're pouring in. And this guy just left it open. And he didn't need legislation because I didn't have legislation. I said, close the border. We had the safest border in history. In that final couple of months of my presidency, we had, according
you're
to the
Mexicans control, is racist, close them borders.
By the way, who endorsed me for president, but I won't say that, but they endorsed me for president. Brandon, just speak to him. But look, we had the
that's
safest border in history. Now we have the worst border in history. There's never been anything like it. And people are dying all over the place, including the people that are coming up in
thank
caravans.
Thank you, President Trump.
Biden
President
Biden.
The only terrorist who's done anything across the border is one who came along and killed three under his administration. Killed an Al-Qaeda person. Come in here.
Yo, this thing. Oh, administration. Oh, oh, wait. This thing is so old. This thing is so old.
I'm not going to lie respectfully, bro. That literally can't be our president for four more years. I'm not saying that. Can't. No terrorist ever got through. The guy's a puppet.
We're
in
our prisons. We're welcoming these people. That's simply
a walking
not true. There's no data to support what he said. Once again, he's exaggerating. He's
bro, here's the thing. This nigga could be speaking facts and nobody's going to give a fuck because this nigga look like a zombie.
You've said that you're going to carry out, quote, the large.
He could be speaking facts. But the memes will prevail.
Unquote. Does that mean that you will deport every undocumented immigrant in America, including those who have jobs, including those whose spouses are citizens, and including those who have lived here for decades? And if so, how will you do it?
Just one second. He said we killed three people. The people we killed are al-Baghdadi and Soleimani, the two greatest terrorists, biggest terrorists anywhere in the world. And it had a huge impact on everything, not just border, on everything. He's the one that killed people with a bad water, including hundreds of thousands of people dying and also killing our citizens when they come in. We are living right now in a rat's nest. They're killing our people in New York.
Yeah, that's
California,
fast. You know, Trump ass old as fuck, too, right? Them
union,
niggas damn near.
We don't have borders.
How old is Trump? But the thing is,
now a border.
Trump is highly functional. I ain't gonna lie. So it's like, it's not really like an age thing. It's like, are you a functional thing?
People are coming in and they're
Trump
killing
age.
Our citizens. At
Trump
a
is
level
78.
We call it migrant crime. I call it Biden.
Joe Biden
crime.
Age.
They're
81.
Citizens at a level that we've never seen before.
They're
and
3 years
reading
apart.
It, like these three incredible young girls over the last few days. One of them, I just spoke to the mother, and they just had the funeral for this girl, 12 years old. This is horrible what's taken place. What's taken place in our country, we're literally an uncivilized country now. He doesn't want it to be. He just doesn't know. He opened the borders. Nobody's ever seen anything like. And we have to get a lot of these people out, or we have to get them out fast, because they're going to destroy our country. Just take a look at where they're living. They're living in luxury hotels in New York City and other places. Our veterans are on the street.
Oh, my God. Hassan's dick is probably
he doesn't care about
so hard right
he
now.
Doesn't care. He doesn't like the military at all, and he doesn't care about our veterans. Nobody's been worse. I had the highest approval rating for veterans taking care of the VA. He has the worst. He's gotten rid of all the things that I approved. Choice that I got through Congress, all of the different things I approved, they abandoned. We had by far the highest, and now it's down in less than half because he's done all these great things that we did. And I think he did it just because I approved it, which is crazy. But he has killed so many people at our border by
thank
allowing
you,
all of these people to come in.
President
and it's
Biden,
a very sad day in America.
President Biden, you have the mic.
Every single thing he said is a lie. Every single one. For example, veterans are a hell of a lot better off since I passed the PACT Act. 1 million of them now have insurance and their families have it. Their families have it because what happened, whether it was Agent Orange or burn pits, they're all being covered now. And he opposed, his group opposed that. We're also in a situation where
I wish he wasn't stuttering,
great respect
bro.
For veterans. My son spent a year in Iraq, living right next to one of those burn pits. Came back with stage 4 glioblastoma. I was recently in France for D-Day, and I spoke all about those heroes that died. I went to the World War II cemetery, World War I cemetery. He refused to go to. He He was standing with his four-star general, and he told him, he said, I don't want to go in there because they're a bunch of losers and suckers. My son was not a loser, was not a sucker. You're the sucker. You're the loser.
Oh, shit.
President Trump?
First of all, that was a made-up quote, suckers and losers. They made it up. It was in a third-rate magazine that's failing, like many of these magazines. He made that up. He put it in commercials. We've notified him. We had 19 people that said I didn't say it. And think of this.
He said, you're the loser.
I'm at a cemetery, or I'm talking about our veterans, because nobody's taking better care. I'm so glad this came up, and he brought it up. There's nobody that's taken better care of our soldiers than I have. To think that I would, in front of generals and others, say, suckers and losers. We have 19 people that said it was never said by me. It was made up by him, just like Russia was made up, just like the 51 intelligence agents are made up, just like the new thing with the 16 economists are talking. It's the same thing. 51 intelligence agents said that the laptop was Russia disinformation. It wasn't. That came from his son, Hunter. It wasn't Russia disinformation. He made up the suckers and losers, so he should apologize to me right now.
Four-star general standing to your side who was on your staff who said you said it, period.
He said,
that's number
said,
one. Oh, yeah. And number two, the idea that I have to apologize to you for anything along the line. We've done more for veterans than any president has in American history.
Oh,
American
shit.
History. And they now are in their family. The only sacred obligation we have as a country is to care for our veterans when they come home and their families and equip them when they go to war. That's what we're doing. That's what the VA is doing now. They're doing more for veterans than ever before in our history.
All right, thank you so much.
Oh, shit.
To the topic of foreign policy.
Oh, shit.
I want to begin with Russia's war against Ukraine, which is now in its third year.
Like I said, Jake Future clone.
Russian President Vladimir Putin says
he'll
finally end
this war. Oh, my God.
I gotta lie.
Trump might go crazy with the Ukraine.
Oh, yeah, he might go crazy. Claimed, and Ukraine abandons its bid to join NATO. Are Putin's terms acceptable to you?
First of all, our veterans and our soldiers can't stand this guy. They can't stand him. They think he's the worst commander-in-chief, if that's what you call him, that
if
we've
that's
ever
what
had.
You call
they can't
him.
Stand him. So let's get that straight. And they like me more than just about any of them. And that's based on every single bit of information. As far as Russia and Ukraine, if we had a real president, a president that knew, that was respected by Putin, he would have never invaded Ukraine. A lot of people are dead right now, much more than people know. You know, they talk about numbers. You can double
those numbers.
He did nothing to stop it. In fact, I think he encouraged Russia from going in. I'll tell you what happened. He was so bad with Afghanistan. It was such a horrible embarrassment, most embarrassing moment in the history of our country, that when Putin watched that and he saw the incompetence, he should have fired those generals like I fired the one that you mentioned. And so he's got no love lost. But he should have fired those generals. No general got fired for the most embarrassing moment in the history of our country, Afghanistan, where we left billions of dollars of equipment behind. We lost 13 beautiful soldiers, and 38 soldiers were obliterated. And by the way, we left people behind, too. We left American citizens behind. When Putin saw that, he said, you know what? I think we're going to go in and maybe take my... This was his dream. I talked to him about it, his dream. The difference is he never would have invaded Ukraine, never, just like Israel would have never been invaded in a million years by Hamas.
Million.
You know why? Because Iran was broke with me. I wouldn't let anybody do business with them. They ran
what
out of money.
What is Joe
they
doing? He's writing down
no
notes.
He locked in. They had no money for anything, no money for terror. That's why you had no terror at all. During
so
my
Israel
administration,
got invaded?
This place, the whole world is blowing up under him.
What the fuck?
President Biden.
Wait, hold on, Joe. Look, the fact that I'm where, let's take the last point first. Iran attacked American troops, caused brain damage for a number of these troops.
They're going to say he got
and he
brain
did
damage.
Nothing about it recently, not when he was president. There they attacked. He said they're just having headaches. That's all it is.
Oh,
he
shit.
He didn't do a thing when the attack took place, number one. Number two. We got over 100,000 Americans and others out of Afghanistan during that airlift. Number three, we found ourselves in a situation where, if you take a look at what Trump did in Ukraine, this guy told Trump, do whatever you want, and do whatever you want. And that's exactly what Trump did. to Putin, encourage him, do whatever you want. And he went in. And listen to what he said when he went in. He was going to take Kyiv in 5 days, remember? Because it's part of the old Soviet Union. That's what he wanted to reestablish, Kyiv. And he, in fact, didn't do it at all. He didn't, wasn't able to get it done. And they've lost over, they've lost thousands and thousands of troops, 500,000 troops.
President Trump, I never come said back that. To you for 1 minute, I just want to go back to my original question.
I never said that.
Are Putin's terms acceptable to you? Keeping the territory in Ukraine?
No, they're not acceptable. But look, this is a war that never should have started. If we had a leader in this war, he led everybody along. He's given $200 billion now or more to Ukraine. He's given $200 billion. That's a lot of money. I don't think there's ever been anything like it. Every time that Zelensky comes to this country, he walks away with $60 billion. He's the greatest salesman ever. And I'm not knocking him. I'm not knocking anything. I'm only saying the money that we're spending on this war, and we shouldn't be spending, it should have never happened. I will have that war settled between Putin and Zelensky as president-elect before I take office on January 20th. I'll have that war settled. People being killed so needlessly, so stupidly, and I will get it settled, and I'll get it settled fast before I take office.
President Biden, you have a minute.
The fact is that Putin is a war criminal. He's killed thousands and thousands of people. And he has made one thing clear. He wants to reestablish what was part of the Soviet Empire. Not just a peace, he wants all of Ukraine. That's what he wants. And then you think he'll stop there? Do you think he'll stop when he, if he takes Ukraine? What do you think happens to Poland? What do you think of Belarus? What do you think happens to those NATO countries? And so if you want a war, you ought to find out what he's going to do, because if, in fact, he does what he says and walks away. By the way, all that money we give Ukraine from weapons we make here in the United States, we give them the weapons, not the money at this point. And our NATO allies have produced as much funding for Ukraine as we have. That's why we're strong.
Thank you. Moving on to the Middle East.
Yo, I ain't gonna lie.
Hamas attacked Israel, killing more than 1,000 people and
like I said, at this point.
Hostages. Among those held and thought to still be alive are 5 Americans.
Good word.
Israel's response has killed thousands of Palestinians and created a humanitarian crisis in Gaza. President Biden, you've put forward a proposal to resolve this conflict, but so far Hamas has not released the remaining hostages, and Israel is continuing its military offensive in Gaza. So what additional leverage will you use to get Hamas and Israel to end the war? You have 2 minutes.
Uh-oh.
Number one,
uh-oh.
Everyone from the United Nations Security Council, straight through the G7, to the Israelis and Netanyahu himself have endorsed the plan I put forward, which has 3 stages to it. The first stage is trade the hostages for a ceasefire. Second phase is a ceasefire with additional conditions. Okay. The third phase is the end of the war. The only one who wants the war to continue is Hamas, number one. They're the only ones standing out. We're still pushing hard to get them to accept. In the meantime, what's happened? In Israel, we're finding that the only thing I've denied Israel was 2,000-pound bombs. They don't work very well in populated areas. They kill a lot of innocent people. We're providing Israel with all the weapons they need and when they need them. And by the way, I'm the guy that organized the world against Iran when they had a full-blown intercontinental ballistic missile attack on Israel. No one was hurt.
Yo, Josh.
One
the fuck? What?
Are you Team Hamas or Team Israel, bruh?
Team whatever the fuck you're not on, buddy. Get out of here.
A support for Israel of anyone in the world.
Team Hamas, bro.
And so they're two different things.
Wayne, bad chats, bro.
Hamas cannot allowed to be continued. We continue to send our experts and our intelligence people as to how they can get Hamas like we did Bin Laden. You don't have to do it. And by the way, they've been greatly weakened, Hamas. Greatly weakened, and they should be. They should be eliminated. But you've got to be careful for what using certain weapons among population centers.
Just going back to Ukraine for 1 second. We have an ocean separating us.
Well, I need to ask my
the European nations
chat.
Together.
Does Hamas equal Palestine? Let me see something.
Or maybe more than that, less than us. Why doesn't he call them? See, better put up your money like I did with NATO. I got them to put up hundreds of billions of dollars. The Secretary General of NATO said Trump did the most incredible job I've ever seen.
That's why Wayne just
They wouldn't have any. They were going out of business. We were spending almost 100% of the money was paid by us. He didn't do that. He's getting all. You got to ask these people to put up the money. We're over $100 billion more spent, and it has a bigger impact on them because of location, because we have an ocean in between. You got to ask them. As far as Israel and Hamas, Israel's the one that wants to go. He said the only one that wants to keep going is Hamas. Actually, Israel is the one, and you should let him go and let him finish the job. He doesn't want to do it. He's become like a Palestinian, but they don't like him because he's a very bad Palestinian. He's a weak one.
Oh, shit.
President Biden, you have a minute?
I've never heard so much foolishness. This is a guy who wants to get out of NATO. Are you going to stay in NATO? He's going to pull out of NATO. The idea that we have, our strength lies in our alliances as well. It may be a big ocean, but are we ever able to avoid a war in Europe, a major war in Europe? What happens if, in fact, you have Putin continue to go into NATO? We have an Article 5 agreement. Attack on one is attack on all. If you want to start the nuclear war he keeps talking about, go ahead. Let Putin go in and control Ukraine and then move on to Poland and other places. See what happens then. He has no idea what the hell he's talking about.
I'm sure.
Support Ukraine, who y'all Japan and South Korea, because they understand that this is...
We can't be talking what he's talking about.
Threat to the whole
he too quiet.
No major war in Europe has ever been able to be contained just to Europe.
President Trump, just to follow up, would you support the creation of an independent Palestinian state in order to achieve peace in the region?
I'd have to see, but before we do that, the problem we have is that we spend all the money. So they kill us on trade. I made great trade deals with the European nations. Because if you add them up, they're about the same size economically. Their economy is about the same size as the United States. And they were no cars, no. They don't want anything that we have, but we're supposed to take their cars, their food, their everything, their agriculture. I changed that. But the big thing I changed is they don't want to pay. And the only reason that he can play games with NATO is because I got them to put up hundreds of billions of dollars. I said, and he's right about this, I said, no, I'm not going to support NATO if you don't pay. They asked me that question. Would you guard us against Russia at a very secret meeting of the 28 states at that time, nations at that time? And they said, no, if you don't pay, I won't do that. And you know what happened? Billions and billions of dollars came flowing in the next day and the next months.
Answer the question,
now
nigga.
Now we're in the same position.
You know how we go.
Thank you. Bills.
Let's turn to the issue of democracy.
He be talking around questions.
About January 6, 2021.
He be talking around questions, bro, every time.
Some of them stormed the Capitol to stop the constitutionally mandated counting of electoral votes. As president, you swore an oath to, quote, preserve, protect, and defend, unquote, the Constitution. What do you say to voters who believe that you violated that oath through your actions and inaction on January 6th and worry that you'll do it again?
Well, I don't think too many believe that. And let me tell you about January 6th. On January 6th, we had a great border. Nobody coming through, very few. On January 6th, we were energy independent. On January 6th, we had the lowest taxes ever. We had the lowest regulations ever. On January 6th, we were respected all over the world. All over the world, we were respected. And then he comes in, and we're now laughed at. We're like a bunch of stupid people. That what happened to the United States' reputation under this man's leadership is horrible, including weaponization, which I'm sure at some point you'll be talking about, where he goes after his political opponent because he can't beat him fair and square.
You have 80 seconds left. My question was, what do you say to those voters who believe that you violated your constitutional oath through your actions and inaction on January 6, 2021, and worry that you'll do it again?
Well, I didn't say that to anybody.
Answer the question.
I said peacefully and patriotically.
And
Nancy Pelosi, if you just watched the news from 2 days ago, on tape to her daughter, who's a documentary filmmaker, they say, but she's saying, oh, no, it's my responsibility. I was responsible for this because I offered her 10,000 soldiers or National Guard, and she turned them down. And the mayor of, in writing, by the way, the mayor, in writing, turned it down, the mayor of D.C. They turned it down. I offered 10,000 because I could see. I had virtually nothing to do. They asked me to go make a speech. I could see what was happening. Everybody was saying they're going to be there on January 6th. They're going to be there. And I said, you know what? There's a lot of people coming. You could feel it. You could feel it too, and you could feel it. And I said, they ought to have some National Guard or whatever. And I offered it to her. And she now admits that she turned it down. And it was the same day she was, I don't know, she can't be very happy with her daughter because it made her into a liar. She said, I take full responsibility for January 6th.
President Biden?
Look, he encouraged those folks to go up on Capitol Hill, number one. I sat in the dining room off the Oval Office. He sat there for 3 hours. 3 hours watching, begging, being begged by his vice president and a number of his colleagues on the Republican side as well to do something, to call for a stop, to end it. Instead, he talked about these people being patriots. And,
hey, Trump low-key like that shit. Patrons of Trump low-key like that shit, bro. I'm not going to let anybody change history. I remember that time, bro.
They've been convicted. He says he wants to commute their sentences and say that, no. But he went to every single court in the nation. I don't know how many cases, scores of cases, including the Supreme Court. And they said, no, no, this guy is responsible for doing what is being that was done.
Hate when this nigga talks, bro. Jesus Christ.
And these people should be in jail. And they should be in ones that are being held accountable. And he wants to let them all out. And now he says if he loses again, such a whiner that he is, that it could be a bloodbath.
Thank you, President Biden. President Trump?
What they've done to some people that are,
bro,
so innocent.
You ought to be, I wish Joe Biden was a good talker, bro.
You have done how you destroyed.
Wait, this nigga
talks
like he's about to die, bro.
When they ripped down Portland, ripped down.
Nigga, dead talk like an anime character on his deathbed, saying they last
Minnesota, Minneapolis, what they've done there with the fires all over the city. If I didn't bring in the National Guard, that city would have been destroyed. When you look at all of the. They took over big chunks of Seattle. I was all set to bring in the National Guard. They heard that. They saw them coming, and they left immediately. What he said about this whole subject is so off. Peacefully patriotic. One other thing. The Unselect Committee, which is basically two horrible Republicans that are all gone now out of office, and Democrats, all Democrats, they destroyed and deleted all of the information they found because they found out we were right. We were right. And they deleted and destroyed all of the information. They should go to jail for that. If a Republican did that, they'd go to jail.
Thank you, President Trump. President Biden, I want to give you a minute.
The only person on this stage is a convicted felon is the man I'm looking at right now.
Oh,
shit. The fact of the matter is, what he's telling you is simply not true. The fact is that there was no effort on his part to stop what was going on up in Capitol Hill. And all those people, every one of those who were convicted, deserves to be convicted. The idea that they didn't kill somebody, just went in and broke down doors, broke the windows, occupied offices, turned over desks, turned them over statues. The idea that those people are patriots? Come on. When I asked them the first two debates we had, the debates we had first time around, I said, will you denounce the Proud Boys? He said, no, I'll tell them to stand by. The idea he's refusing to, will you denounce these guys? We denounce the people we're talking about now. We denounce the people who attacked that Capitol. What are you going to do?
I'm going to give you a minute, President Trump, for a follow-up question I have. After a jury convicted you of 34 felonies last month, you said if reelected, you would, quote, have every right to go after, unquote, your political opponents. You just talked about members of the Select Committee on January 6th going to jail. Your main political opponent is standing on stage with you tonight. Can you clarify exactly what it means about you feeling you have every right to go after your political opponents?
Well, I said my retribution is going to be success. We're going to make this country successful again because right now it's a failing nation. My retribution is going to be success. But when he talks about a convicted felon, his son is a convicted felon at a very high level.
Holy,
his son is convicted.
Going to
be convicted probably numerous
times. His son,
should have been convicted before, but his
terrible,
Justice
bro.
Department let the statute of limitations lapse, and the most important thing, but he could be a convicted felon as soon as he gets out of office. Joe could be a convicted felon with all of the things that he's done. He's done horrible things. All of the death calls.
Why everybody got
border,
bad skeletons,
telling the Ukrainian people that we're going to want $1 billion or you change the prosecutor. Otherwise, you're not getting $1 billion. Have I ever said that? That's quid pro quo. That we're not going to do anything. We're not going to give you $1 billion unless you change your prosecutor having to do with the son. This man is a criminal. This man, you're lucky. You're lucky. I did nothing wrong. We'd have a system that was rigged and disgusting. I did nothing wrong.
Thank you, President Trump. President Biden, you have said, I'm coming right to you, sir. You want to respond? Go ahead. I'll give you a minute to respond.
The idea that I did anything wrong relative to what you're talking about is outrageous. It's simply a lie, number one. Number two, the idea that you have a right to seek retribution against any American just because you're president is wrong. It's simply wrong. No president's ever spoken like that before. No president in our history has spoken like that before. Number three, the crimes that you are still charged with, and think of all the civil penalties you have. How many billions of dollars do you owe in civil penalties for molesting a woman in public, for doing a whole range of things, having sex with a porn
star? Are determined to destroy American democracy. Do you believe that the tens of millions of Americans who are likely to vote for President Trump will be voting against American democracy?
The more they know about what he's done, yes. The more they know about what he's done. And there's a lot more coming. He's got a lot of cases down the road coming around. He's got a whole range of issues he has to face. I don't know what the juries will do, but I do know he has a real problem. And so the fact that, could you ever think you hear any president say that I'm going to seek retribution? Do you ever hear any president say that I thought Hitler had some good ideas? Jesus, what got me involved to run in the first place after my son had died, I decided in Iraq, because of Iraq, I said I wasn't going to run again until I saw what happened in Charlottesville, Virginia. People coming out of the woods carrying swastikas on torches, and singing the same anti-Semitic bile they sang when back in Germany. And the young woman got killed. I spoke to the mother, and they asked him. They said, "What do you think of those people?
The people who the ones got killed, one who tried to stop it,
and the one who said I think they're fine people on both sides."
Like, I'm dead ass. What,
bro?
American
he started a point, like, and then he just realizes that he doesn't know how to speak anymore. Like he's just like, "Bro, this is fucking gone."
Singing the same anti-Semitic bile,
carrying swastikas.
Forgot what the fuck I was talking about.
Fine people. This is the guy who says Hitler's done some good things. I'd like to know what they are. Good things Hitler's done, that's what he said. This guy has no sense of American democracy.
President Trump.
Jake, both of you know that, sir, has been totally wiped out, because when you see the sentence, it said 100% exoneration on that, sir. He just keeps it going. He says he ran because of Charlottesville. He didn't run because of Charlottesville. He ran because it was his last chance. He's not equipped to be president. You know it, and I know it. It's ridiculous. We have a debate. We're trying to justify his presidency. His presidency, he's without question the worst president, the worst presidency in the history of our country. We shouldn't be having a debate about it. There's nothing to debate. He made up the Charlottesville story, and you'll see it's debunked all over the place. Every anchor has every reasonable anchor has debunked it. And just the other day it came out where it was fully debunked. It's a nonsense story. He knows that. And he didn't run because of it. He used that as an excuse to run.
What is he looking at, man?
It debunked. It happened. All you have to do is listen to what was said at the time. And the idea that somehow that's the only reason I ran. I ran because I was worried a guy like this guy could get elected. If he thought they were good people coming out of that forest, carrying those woods, carrying those torches, then he didn't deserve to be president. Didn't deserve to be president at all. And the idea that he's talking about all this being fabricated, we saw with our own eyes. We saw what happened on January 6th. We saw the people breaking through the windows. We saw people occupying his own vice president. Look, there's a reason why 40 of his 44 top cabinet officers refused to endorse him this time. His vice president hasn't endorsed him this time. So why? Why? They know him well. They serve with him. Why are they not endorsing him?
Thank you, President Biden. We're going to be right back with more from the CNN presidential debate.
This country's finished. That's what the past 10 minutes I've just fucking told me. This country's fucking finished.
A manageable situation for Biden that, like, makes Trump look worse and Biden look better. Because every fucking frame, side by side, he's looking like a doddering old fool looking in the other direction. It's so fucking bad.
He's staring in his face.
Yeah, and obviously the massive moment of the debate is like when he flubbed it, when he just went and then just like stopped himself.
Bro,
every moment.
Bro, the memes are gonna kill, bro.
The split screen is absolutely cooking him, because I don't think he's aware that he's on camera all the time. And when he's on camera all the time, he just looks like he's like gazing off and seeing fucking the Grim Reaper in the other side of the goddamn room. You know what I mean? Does he still believe his pre-debate take? New article on debate tomorrow.
Bro. Yeah,
a minute.
I was.
That nigga Biden dead looked off like he was gonna die.
Bro, Biden could. Biden could be speaking fast. Nobody's like, bro. The nigga is not coherent, gang.
That this shit is actually sad.
Oh, thank you for the gifted. Who gifted me?
At least Donald Trump is attempting to manipulate his words, bro. He's trying, bro.
She won that first debate in 2016. She like did a good job then.
Biden is a puppy. He doesn't run shit. Oh, yo, this nigga thinks the president runs shit. This nigga think Trump gets in here, he's gonna be running shit.
Crazy. It's actually fucking crazy. It is.
We're fucked regardless.
Obama!
Welcome back to the CNN presidential debate live from Georgia. Let's talk about persistent challenges you both faced in the first term, and you'd certainly face again I feel like in the second term. President Biden, while black unemployment dropped to a record low black families still earn far less than white families. Black mothers are still three times more likely to die from pregnancy-related causes, and black Americans are imprisoned at five times the rate of white Americans.
Yeah, because they're hoodlums.
What do you say to black voters who are disappointed that you haven't made more progress?
We acknowledge you made a lot of progress, number one.
I gotta lie, you can't put that on one president to change a whole fucking thing. God damn.
Number two, black unemployment is the lowest level it's been in a long, long time. Number three, we're finding housing for black Americans and dealing with the segregation that exists among these corporate people out of their houses. And in addition to that, we find that the impact of on the
oh my the God
choice.
I can't listen to this.
It's like secondhand embarrassment, difficult. Bro.
When we did the first major piece of legislation in the past, I was able to reduce black child care costs. I cut them in half. In half. We got to make sure we provide for child care costs.
Yeah.
We got to make sure, because when you provide those child care protections, you
type shit.
Like, his facts are good, but like, goddamn. Beach.
So, bro, there's more to be done. Considerably more to be done.
Imagine if you could talk like Obama. A great deal so far,
and I'm not letting up, and they know it.
You have 49 seconds left. What do you say to black voters who are disappointed with the progress so far?
I say I don't blame them for being disappointed. Inflation is still hurting them badly. For example, I provided for the idea that any black family, first-time home buyer, should get a $10,000 tax credit to buy their first home. So they can get started. I made sure they were in a situation where all those black families and those black individuals who provided had to take out student loans that were ballooning.
Come on, that if stay they on track.
Engaged in nursing.
We're almost there.
Anything having to do
with
that.
Fuck!
Bills for 10 years.
Bro, we were right debt. There.
All the rest were given after 10 years. Millions have benefited from
that's true. My mom got benefited. My uncle got benefited. I ain't gonna lie. That's true. Sir. It was gone. Woke up. $80,000 gone. No
and he
cap.
Caused the inflation. Yes, sir. He's blaming inflation. And he's right. It's been very bad.
My guy.
He caused the inflation. And it's killing black families and Hispanic families.
He was inaugurated at the peak of the pandemic.
It's killing people.
He was like, what the fuck?
Buy groceries anymore. They can't.
When yo has put all these policies in the fuck.
And tripled and quadrupled. They can't live. They're not living anymore. He caused this inflation. I gave him a country with no inflation.
Bro,
he was perfect. It was so good. All he had to do
was
leave it alone.
The pandemic was about to start, and the nigga said, nah, we don't got to do nothing. We don't got to do shit about
it. All this money that's being thrown out the window. He caused inflation. As sure as you're sitting there, the fact is that his big kill on the black people is the millions of people that he's allowed to come in through the border. They're taking black jobs now. And it could be 18, it could be 19, and even 20 million people. They're taking black jobs, and they're taking Hispanic jobs, and you haven't seen it yet, but you're going to see something that's going to be the worst in our history.
Thank you. President Biden?
There was no inflation when I became president. You know why? The economy was flat on its back. 15% unemployment. He decimated the economy. Absolutely decimated the economy. That's why there was no inflation at the time. There were no jobs. Provided thousands of millions of jobs for individuals who are in all communities, including minority communities. We made sure that they have health insurance. We have covered, if the ACA has increased, I made sure that their $8,000 per person in the family to get written off for health care.
Come on.
But this guy wants to eliminate that. They tried 50 times. He wants to get rid of the ACA again, and they're going to try again if they win. You find ourselves in a position where the idea that we're not doing any, we put more police on the street than any administration has. He wants to cut the cops. We're providing for equity and making sure people have a shot to make it. There's a lot going on, but in inflation, he caused it by his tremendous malfeasance in the way he handled the pandemic.
Thank you. Another persistent challenge is the climate crisis.
I don't know what he said at the end.
2023
like, I know what
was
he's
the hottest year in recorded history, and communities across the country are confronting devastating effects of extreme heat, intensifying wildfires, stronger hurricanes, and rising
I'm thinking niggas have like amnesia.
Former
like,
President
they be forgetting
Trump,
how shit was like 4 years ago, bro.
Climate initiatives, but will you take any action as president to slow the climate crisis?
Let me just go back to what he said about the police.
First,
the police are to him. Almost every police group in the nation from every state is supporting Donald J. Trump. Almost every police group. And what he's done to the black population is horrible, including the fact that for 10 years he called them super predators. We can't, in the 1990s, we can't forget that. Super predators was his name, and he called it to them for 10, and they've taken great offense at it, and now they see it happening. But when they see what I did for criminal justice reform and for the historically black colleges and universities, where I funded them and got them all funded, and the opportunity zones with Tim, as you know, Tim Scott was incredible. He did a great job. Great senator from South Carolina. He came to me with the idea, and it was a great idea. It's one of the most successful economic development acts ever in the country, opportunity zones. And the biggest beneficiary are blacks. And that's why we have the best numbers with them in maybe ever. They're saying ever. I read this morning where ever, the best numbers. He's lost much of the black population because he's done a horrible job for black people. He's also done a horrible job for Hispanics. But wait till you see these millions of people pouring into our country, and they're going to take the jobs, and it's already started, and you haven't seen anything yet. It's a disaster.
You've 38 seconds left. President Trump, will you take any action as president to slow the climate crisis?
So I want absolutely immaculate clean water, and I want absolutely clean air, and we had it. We had H2O. We had the best numbers ever. And
we're
we were using all forms of energy, all forms, everything. And yet, during my 4 years, I had the best environmental numbers ever. And my top environmental people gave me that statistic just before I walked on the stage, actually.
Nigga said,
bring back H2O. Yo, bring back H2O.
Danny, he says it's true. I passed the most extensive climate change legislation in history. We find ourselves, and by the way, black colleges. I came up with $15 billion for HBCUs, historic black universities and colleges, because they don't have the kind of contributors that they have to build these laboratories and the like. Any black student is capable in college of doing any white student can do. They just don't have the money, but now they'll be able to get those jobs in high tech. We're in a situation where the idea that he is claiming to have done something that had the cleanest water. He hadn't done a damn thing in the environment. He pulled out of the Paris Peace Accord, Climate Accord. I immediately joined it because if we reach 1.5 degrees Celsius at any one point, there's no way back. The only existential threat to humanity is climate change, and he didn't do a damn thing about it. He wants to undo all that I've done.
Not sure. Nuclear war.
The Paris Accord was going to cost us $1 trillion. And China nothing, and Russia nothing, and India nothing. It was a ripoff of the United States. And I ended it because I didn't want to waste that money because they treat us horribly. We were the only ones. It was costing us money. Nobody else was paying into it. And it was a disaster. But everything that he said just now, I'll give you an example. I heard him say before, insulin. I'm the one that got the insulin down for the seniors. I took care of the seniors. What he's doing is destroying all of our medical programs because the migrants coming in, they want everybody. And look, I have the biggest heart on the stage. I guarantee you that. And I want to take care of people. But we're destroying our country. They're taking over our schools, our hospitals, and they're going to be taking over Social Security. He is destroying Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid.
Nigga, does this nigga care about anything else other than that goddamn wall?
We, in fact, we were the only ones of consequence who were not members of the Paris Accord. How can we do anything if we're not able to, the United States can't get us under control? One of the largest polluters in the world, number one. We're making significant progress. By 2035, we will have cut pollution in half. We have made significant progress, and we're continuing to make progress. We set up a climate corps. For thousands of young people will learn how to deal with climate, just like the Peace Corps. And we're moving in directions that are going to significantly change the elements of cause of pollution. But the idea that he claims that he has the biggest heart up here and he's really concerned about pollution and about climate, I've not seen any indication of that. And by the way, with regard to prescription drugs, one company agreed that they would reduce the price to $35, which I was calling for, one, voluntarily. I made sure every company in the world, every pharmaceutical company, cannot have to pay.
Thank you.
And by the way...
So every day, millions of Americans struggle just to make ends meet. For many older Americans, Social Security provides a critical lifeline. President Biden, if nothing is done to Social Security, seniors will see their benefits cut in just over 10 years. Will you name tonight one specific step that you're willing to take to keep Social Security solvent? Oh,
yes, make the very wealthy begin to pay their fair share. Right now, everybody making under $170,000 pays 6% of their income, of their paycheck, every single time they get a paycheck from the time of the first one they get when they're 18 years old. The idea that they're going to, I'm proposing that everybody, they pay, the millionaires pay 1%. So no one after, I would not raise the cost of Social Security for anybody under $400,000. After that, I began to make the wealthy begin to pay their fair share by increasing from 1% beyond to be able to guarantee the program for life.
So you still have 82 seconds left. Are there any other measures that you think that would be able to help keep Social Security solvent, or is that one enough?
Well, no, that one enough will keep it solvent. But the biggest thing I'll do if we defeat this man, because he wants to get rid of Social Security. He thinks there's plenty to cut in Social Security. He's wanted to cut Social Security and Medicare, both times. And that's what, and if you look at the program put forward by the House Republican Caucus that he, I believe, supports, is in fact want to cut it as well. The idea that we don't need to protect our seniors is ridiculous. And by the way, the American public has greater health care coverage today than ever before. And on the ACA, as I said, you're in a circumstance where 400,000 people.
I fought with Trump with the taxes. That's it. I ain't gonna lie.
They don't have insurance because they have a pre-existing condition. Right. Only thing allows them to have that insurance is the fact that they, in fact, are part of the ACA. And by the way, the other thing is, we're in a situation where we talk about education for black communities. I've raised the amount of money for Pell Grants. Another $8,000 for anybody making under $15,000.
I ain't gonna lie, I know niggas trapping off their Pell Grants.
$15,000 towards the
I know niggas trapping off their Pell Grants. Crazy, bro.
Just don't know what I'm gonna keep it a stack.
Thank you, President Biden, President Trump.
So I've dealt with politicians all my life. I've been on this side of the equation for the last 8 years. I've never seen anybody lie like this guy. He lies. I've never seen it. He could look you in the face. So about so many other things, too. And we mentioned the laptop. We mentioned Russia, Ukraine. Everything he does is a lie. It's misinformation and disinformation. The losers and suckers story that he made up is a total lie on the military. It's a disgrace. But Social Security, he's destroying it because millions of people are pouring into our country, and they're putting them onto Social Security. They're putting them onto Medicare, Medicaid. They're putting them in our hospitals. They're taking the place of our citizens there. What they're doing to the VA, to our veterans, is unbelievable. Our veterans are living in the street, and these people are living in luxury hotels. He doesn't know what he's doing, and it's really coming back. I've never seen such anger in our country before.
President Biden?
The idea that veterans were not being taken care of, I told you before. And by the way, when I said suckers and losers, he said he acknowledged after that he fired that general. That general got fired because he's the one that acknowledged that that's what he said. He was the one standing with Trump when he said it, number one. Number two, the idea that we're going to be in a situation where all of these millions and millions, the way he talks about it, illegal aliens are coming into the country and taking away our jobs. There's a reason why we have the fastest growing economy in the world. The reason why we have the most successful economy in the world.
We're doing
better than any other nation in the world. And by the way, those 15 Nobel laureates he talked about being phony, those 15 Nobel laureates, economists, they all said that if Trump is reelected, we're likely to have a recession and inflation is going to increasingly go up. And by the way, worst president in history, 159 presidential scholars voted him the worst president in the history of the United States of America.
President Biden, thank you so much. Let's turn to the cost of child care, which many American families struggle to afford. President Trump, both you and President Biden have tried to address this issue. But the average cost of child care in this country has risen to more than $11,000 a year per child for many families.
I feel like I could beat these niggas.
The cost of child care for two children is more than their rent.
Jesus Christ.
In your second term, what would you do to make child care more affordable?
Just to go back, the general got fired because he was no good. And if he said that, that's why he made it up. But we have 19 people that said I didn't say it, and they're very... He never fired people. I've never seen him fire anybody. I did fire a lot. I fired Comey because he was no good. I fired a lot of the top people at the FBI. They were no good. Not easy to fire people. You'd pay a price for it, but they were no good. I inherited these people. I didn't put them there. I didn't put Comey there. He was no good. Fired him. This guy hasn't fired anybody. He never fires. He should have fired every military man that was involved with that Afghanistan horror show. The most embarrassing moment in the history of our country. He didn't fire. Did you fire anybody? Did you fire anybody that's on the border that's allowed us to have the worst border in the history of the world? Did anybody get fired for allowing 18 million people, many from prisons, many from mental institutions? Did you fire anybody that allowed our country to be destroyed? Joe, our country is being destroyed as you and I sit up here and waste a lot of time on this debate. This shouldn't be a debate. He is the worst president. He just said about me because I said it. But look, he's the worst president in the history of our country. He's destroyed our country. Now all of a sudden he's trying to get a little tough on the border. He came out with a nothing deal. And it reduced it a little bit, rebuild, like bro. This much. It's insignificant. He wants open borders. He wants our country to either be destroyed or he wants to pick up those people as voters. And I don't think we just can't let it happen. If he wins this election, our country doesn't have a chance, not even a chance, of coming out of this rut. We probably won't have a country left anymore. That's how bad it is. He is the worst in history by far.
Thank you, President Trump. President Biden?
We are the most admired country in the world. United States of America.
There's
nothing beyond our capacity. We have the finest military in the history of the world. The finest in the history of the world. No one thinks we're weak. No one wants to screw around with us. Nobody. Number one. Mm-hmm. Number two, the idea that we're talking about worst presidents. I wasn't joking. Look it up.
Russia's not scared of us, gang.
159 or 58, don't hold me the exact number. Presidential historians, they've had meetings and they voted who's the worst president in American history. One through best to worst. They said he was the worst in all of American history. That's a fact. that's not conjecture. He can argue they're wrong, but that's what they voted. The idea that he is doing anything to deal with child care. He did virtually nothing to child care.
So are these two the worst of all time? If you're going neck and neck with the worst of all time?
Significantly increase the availability of women and men, of single parents, to be able to go back to work. And we should encourage businesses to have.
Thank you, President Biden. President Trump, the question was about what would you do to make child care more affordable?
I truly believe, like, in the future, like 50 years from now, niggas will be looking back at these niggas laughing.
We have other things that they rate him the worst because what he's done is so bad. And they rate me, I'll show you, I will show you. And they rate me one of the best, okay? And if I'm given another 4 years, I will be the best. I think I'll be the best. Nobody's ever created an economy like us. Nobody ever cut taxes like us. He's the only one I know. He wants to raise your taxes by four times. He wants to raise everybody's taxes by four times. He wants the Trump tax cuts.
What
is
what?
So everybody, including the two of you, are going to pay four to five times. Nobody ever heard of this before.
What do you mean four to five times, nigga?
And I see politicians talking about cutting taxes. When we cut taxes, as I said, we did more business. Apple and all these companies, they were bringing money back into our country.
I get taxed four
the worst president in history by far, and everybody knows it.
President Biden?
Look, the fact of the matter is that he's dead wrong about
it. Oh, okay, bet.
He's increased the tariff. He will increase the taxes on middle-class people. I said I never
made a
tax on anyone less than $400,000. I didn't. But this tariff is 10% tariffs. Everything coming into the country, you know what the economists say?
I'm playing. I'm middle-class, Chad. I'm playing.
$2,500 a year more because they're going to have to pay the difference in food and all the things that are important.
How do you feel about that?
Number two, he's in a situation where he talks about how he is not raised. He's somehow helped middle class. Now you want
nobody
to
o- nobody under
400k dollars over the next 10 years, which has been a fundamental tax country. You have the largest deficit of any president in American history. Number one. Number two, you have not, in fact, made any contact, any progress with China.
Whatever's better for the people, bro.
The lowest trade deficit with China since 2010.
Thank you, President Biden. Thank you, President Biden. Let's discuss an epidemic impacting millions of Americans that both of you have made a top priority in your first term.
The
opioid crisis. And for both of you, the number of overdose deaths in this country has gone up. Under your term, it went up. Under your term, it has gone up. Former President Trump, despite the efforts that both of you have made, more than 100,000 Americans are dying from overdoses every year, primarily from fentanyl and other opioids. What will you do to help Americans right now in the throes of addiction who are struggling to get the treatment they need?
To finish up, we now have the largest deficit in the history of our country under this guy. We have the largest deficit with China. He gets paid by China. He's a Manchurian candidate. He gets money from China. So I think he's afraid to deal with them or something. But do you notice he never took out my tariffs because we bring in so much money with the tariffs that I imposed on China. He never took them away. He can't because it's too much money. It's tremendous. And we saved our steel industries and there was more to come, but he hasn't done that. But he hasn't cut the tariffs because he can't, because it's too much money. But he's got the largest deficit in the history of our country, and he's got the worst situation with China. China's going to own us if you keep allowing them to do what they're doing to us as a country. They are killing us as a country, Joe, and you can't let that happen. You're destroying our country.
So, President Trump, you have 67 seconds left. The question was, what are you going to do to help Americans in the throes of addiction right now who are struggling to get the treatment they need?
Jake, we were doing very well at addiction until the COVID came along. We had the 2.5, almost 3 years of like nobody's ever had before, any country in every way. And then we had to get tough. And it was the drugs pouring across the border where it started to increase. We got great equipment. We bought the certain dog. That's the most incredible thing that you've ever seen, the way they can spot it. We did a lot.
This happened a week ago.
Very, very low numbers. Then he came along. The numbers, have you seen the numbers now? It's not only the 18 million people that I believe is even low because the gotaways, they don't even talk about gotaways, but the numbers of the amount of drugs and human trafficking in women coming across our border, the worst thing I've ever seen, at numbers that nobody's ever seen under him because the border's so bad. But the number of drugs coming across our border now is the largest we've ever had by far.
President Trump, thank you. President Biden?
Fentanyl and the byproducts of fentanyl went down for a while. And I wanted to make sure we use the machinery that can detect fentanyl, these big machines that roll over everything that comes across the border. And it costs a lot of money. That was part of this deal we put together, this bipartisan deal. More fentanyl machines, more be able to detect drugs, more numbers of agents, more numbers of all the people at the border. And when we had that deal done, he called his Republican colleagues and said, don't do it. It's going to hurt me politically. No, he never argued.
Don't crush my fence, please.
It's a really good deal. We need those machines. and we're coming down very hard in every country in Asia in terms of precursors for fentanyl. And Mexico is working with us to make sure they don't have the technology to be able to put it together. That's what we have to do. We need those machines.
Thank you, President Biden. President Trump, and again, the question is about
Americans
in the throes of addiction right now, struggling to get the treatment they need.
Well, this, because this does pertain to it. He ended Remain in Mexico. He ended catch and release. I made it catch and release in Mexico, not catch and release here. We had so many things that we had done, hard negotiations with Mexico, and I got it all for nothing. It's just like when you have a hostage. We always pay $6 billion for
billion.
A hostage every time we say it's a hostage. Now we have a hostage, a Wall Street Journal reporter, I think a good guy. And he's over there because Putin is laughing at this guy, probably asking for billions of dollars.
Billions.
For the reporter. I will have him out very quickly as soon as I take office. Before I take office, I said by literally as soon as I win the election, I will have that reporter out. He should have had him out a long time ago. But Putin's probably asking for billions and billions of dollars because this guy pays it every time. We had two cases where he paid $6 billion for five people.
Billion.
I got 58 people out, and I paid essentially nothing.
Thank you, President Trump. Dana?
Let's turn to concerns that voters have about each of you. President Biden, you would
billions
be 86
and billions.
At the end of your second term.
Oba.
How do you address concerns
Oba.
About your capability Oba. To handle the toughest job in the world well into your 80s?
Well, first of all, I spent half my career being criticized, being the youngest person in politics. I was the second youngest person ever elected to the United States Senate, and now I'm the oldest. This guy's 3 years younger and a lot less competent.
Oh, shit!
Look at the record. Look at what I've done. Look how I've turned around the horrible situation he left me. As I said, 15 million new jobs, 800,000 manufacturing jobs.
Oh, shit!
In America, over million, billions of dollars in private investment in enterprises that we are growing. We brought an awful lot of people. The whole idea of computer chips. We used to have 40% of the market. We invented those chips, and we lost it because he was sending people to find the cheapest jobs overseas and to bring home a product. So I went to South Korea. I convinced Samsung to invest billions of dollars here in the United States. And guess what? Those fabs, they call them, to build these chips. Those fabs pay over $100,000. You don't need a college degree for them. And there's billions, about $40 billion already being invested and being built right now in the United
billions.
States, creating
billions.
Significant jobs
billions.
For Americans
billions.
All over the, from all over the
billions.
World.
Billions.
President Biden, you have 40 seconds left. Would you like to add anything?
Yeah, I would. The idea that somehow we are this failing country. I never heard a president talk like this before. We're the envy of the world. Name me a single major country president who wouldn't trade places with the United States of America for all our problems and all our opportunities. We're the most progressive country in the world in getting things done.
Oh,
we're the strongest
shit.
Country in the world. We're a country in the world who keeps our word, and everybody trusts us, all of our allies, and those who he coddles up to, from Kim Jong-un, he sends love letters to, and Putin, etc. They don't want to screw.
Thank you. Former President Trump, to follow up, you would be 82 at the end of your second term.
Yo.
What do you say to voters who have concerns about your campaign?
I have no problem. I have no
well,
questions
I took
with
two
Trump's
tests,
health.
Cognitive tests. I aced them, both of them, as you know. We made it public. He took none. I'd like to see him take one, just one, a real easy one. I go through the first five questions. He couldn't do it.
Physical couldn't do it.
Exams
yeah,
every
this
year.
Thing is stupid.
And, you know, we knock on wood wherever we may have wood. That I'm in very good health.
I just right here for you,
two
coach.
Club championships, not even senior. Fuck. Two regular club championships. To do that, you have to be quite smart, and you have to be able to hit the ball a long way. And I do it. He doesn't do it. He can't hit a ball 50 yards. He challenged me to a golf match. He can't hit a ball 50 yards. I think I'm in very good shape. I feel that I'm as in good a shape as I was 25, 30 years ago. Actually, I'm probably a little bit lighter, but I'm in as good a shape as I was.
I'm alive. If you 80,
I feel very
you push
good.
It 80, you feel just as good
but
as
when
you're 50. There's something wrong with you. If you're 50, gang.
And
ain't
you know
no
what?
Way.
I didn't
80,
do well.
50?
I aced him. Dr. Ronnie Jackson.
Or maybe he's superhuman.
A great guy when he was White House doctor. And then I took another one, a similar one. And both, one of them said they'd never seen anybody ace him.
Thank you. President Biden.
Yo, yo, this nigga's such a capper.
Having only 225 pounds, or 235 pounds.
Oh shit, fat shaming.
6'4", 200. Well, anyway, that's what you're. Anyway, just take a look at what he says. And he isn't. Take a look at what he is. I'd be happy to have a driving contest with him. Kareem, I got my handicap, which when I was vice president, down to a 6. And well, by the way, I told you before, I'm happy to play golf if you carry your own bag.
Oh, shit!
You can do it.
Oh, shit.
He's a 6 handicap of all.
I was an 8 handicap.
Yeah.
8. But I have, you know how many?
I've seen you swing. I know you swing.
President Trump. I've seen you. What is happening?
A specific concern that voters.
What is happening?
Will you pledge tonight that once all legal challenges have been exhausted, that you will accept the results of this election, regardless of who wins, and you will say right now that political violence in any form is unacceptable?
Well, I shouldn't have to say that, but of course I believe that. It's totally unacceptable. And if you would see my statements that I made on Twitter at the time, and also my statement that I made in the Rose Garden, you would say it's one of the strongest statements you've ever seen. In addition to the speech I made in front of, I believe, the largest crowd I've ever spoken to. And I will tell you, nobody ever talks about that. They talk about a relatively small number of people that went to the Capitol and in many cases were ushered in by the police. And as Nancy Pelosi said, it was her responsibility, not mine. She said that loud and clear. But the answer is, if the election is fair, free, and I want that more than anybody. And I'll tell you something. I wish he was a great president because I wouldn't be here right now. I'd be at one of my many places.
Oh, he's here to save the day.
Myself. But I wouldn't be under.
Oh, he's here to save the country.
I wouldn't have been his political opponent. Because he indicted me because I was his opponent. I wish he was a great president. I would rather have attacked if I were president.
Trump, the question was, will you accept the results of the election? Regardless of who wins, yes or no, please.
If it's a fair and legal and good
they gonna say
election,
they rigged the ballots.
Absolutely.
No, he not.
Much
fuck no, he not.
These,
fuck no, he
the,
not.
The fraud.
And that's what this nigga not gonna do.
Ridiculous. And if you want, we'll have a news conference on it in a week. Or we'll have another one of these on in a week.
Oh, my
but
God.
I will absolutely. There's nothing I'd rather do. It would be much easier for me to do that than I'm running again. I wasn't really going to run until I saw the horrible job he did. He's destroying our country. I would be very happy to be someplace else in a nice location someplace. And again, no indictments, no political opponent stuff, because it's the only way he thinks he can win. But unfortunately, it's driven up my numbers and driven them up to a very high level because the people understand it.
Well, let's see what your numbers are when this election is over. Let's see. You're a whiner. When you lost the first time, you continued, you appealed and appealed to courts all across the country. Not one single court in America said any of your claims had any merit.
But the chatter
state or
in
local,
my kick chat.
None. But
knows
you
facts.
Continue to provoke this lie about somehow there was all this misrepresentation, all this stealing. There is no evidence of that at all. And I tell you what, I doubt whether you'll accept it because you're such a whiner. The idea if you lose
this
again,
so
you,
much troll.
Anything, you can't stand the loss. Something snapped in you when you lost the last time.
Oh, shit.
We'll be right
yo,
back.
Yo, Trump the big. Yo, that nigga Trump.
The CNN presidential debate live from Georgia.
Trump might be the funniest president of all time. No, not by his. Trump got to be the funniest president of all time. That nigga got to be the funniest president of all time, bro. The hands down funniest president of all time, bro. That nigga's comedy, bro. Is it over? Is that the end of third quarter?
Bro, I've never seen a flyer with this little aura, bro. this shit is dead ass.
Yo, this shit butt. Yo, this shit bad butt. Yo, look at the nigga. Look at the nigga. Bro, this nigga not even looking at where he's supposed to be looking. They probably told this nigga look straight ahead. This nigga looking into nothingness. This nigga Trump look like a fucking. I don't know what he look like, bro. Michael Zowski, look at the neck.
He like a turkey, bro. He like a turkey, bro. You got the good gizzard, bro.
One head of hair between them both.
You got the gizzard, bro.
I'm not gonna lie. I told him we'll push back because I don't want it to be on during any time the debate is because your chat is.
I know, bro.
So, the debate's actually fun to watch, and also it's like that. I mean, we'll be fine. We can start whenever, but this has numbers.
How much longer is the left? Is this the last part?
It's supposed to be 90 minutes, and it's been 90 minutes.
It's been that. That's why I thought it was over. That's why I was. But
I think I'm pretty sure the next break's the last.
Yeah, I don't think the timeouts count. That's why.
So they got 15 more minutes. That's why I said 10:30ish.
Bro, these niggas started arguing about golf.
Yo, that was so unserious. That shit was so unserious. That shit was so unserious. That shit was so unserious.
You're 255. Like what?
Nigga said. First of all, I'm happy to accept a driving competition. First of all, I'm happy to accept a driving competition.
That just pissed Biden off, and because Biden is like beyond like being old and like incompetent and whatever, he's just a complete just like child about this type of stuff. He hates all the Obama people. Like he thinks that they all tried to like end his career like to help Hillary. And so
to be fair, they did tell him not to run, and like we do know that that was an error because like if he had back then, course, he would have won.
Oh my god,
so
this nigga got cooked.
He just like kept that resentment going.
Hold on, is Destiny live chat?
He never stopped with that resentment. And
he's like a Nixonian figure.
Yeah, there's no shot Destiny's not live, bro. Where that Destiny nigga at? That nigga's not live. Doesn't he stream on YouTube? Where that nigga stream at? Or is it Kick? Oh, he's just on Kick. They should not YouTube.
He's ghost walking his way through his
conversation. Well, also, his non-verbal is complete dog shit.
Oh, you mean the crazy faces?
His faces, his reactions.
Bro, niggas
whatever.
Ugly as shit.
Like, I know this is not, like, people don't look into that much. This is just
they might. I don't
the
know.
The look of his eyes, the shape of his eyes are. He always looks like he's pity and he's losing. He looks like he's losing.
Bubba probably watching this face shit in disgust.
Yeah. I don't know, man. This is some keynote facial expressions. Why does it matter if he signals to his audience? What benefit does that give him? He already has them. Because you're trying to turn out voters. You're trying to get people to go and show up at the polls and vote.
I'm going
to deliver their closing statements as predetermined by a coin toss. We're going to begin with you, President Biden. You have 2 minutes.
Oh, this is the final. This is the final. This is
final. Fourth quarter. Fourth quarter, Jeff. Fourth quarter.
Statements as predetermined by a coin toss. We're going to begin with new president.
What does that sound?
We've made.
I thought he had a stroke.
In the debacle that was left by President Trump in his last term.
GG's.
We find ourselves in a situation where, number one, we have to make sure that we have a fair tax system. I ask anyone out there in the audience, or anyone out watching this debate, do you think the tax system is fair? The fact is that I said nobody even making under $400,000 had a single penny increase in their taxes and will not. And if I'm reelected, that'll be the case again. But this guy
is looking at you, chat.
Taxes because of the deficit, number one. He's increased inflation because of the debacle he left after the way he handled the pandemic. And he finds himself in a position where he now wants to tax you more by putting a 10% tariff on everything that comes into the United States of America.
Okay.
What I did was, for example, he wants to get rid of the ability of Medicare for us to be able to negotiate with big pharma companies. Well, guess what?
Say something about Palestine.
We got it down to $35.
Oh my god.
Instead of
just say free Palestine. Just say free Palestine.
Just say it.
Alt. You're cooked.
You can't say free Palestine. How much prescription they need?
You know what that
means? You got to switch it up.
And they gave $1 billion.
You got to switch it up.
$1 billion. Let me say my bad, bro.
Because the government turned out to pay the exorbitant price. I'm going to make that available to every senior. All along, it's happening now, and everybody in America. He wants to get rid of that. I'm going to make sure that we have child care. We're going to significantly increase the credits people have for child care. We're going to make sure we do something about what we're doing on lead pipes and all the things that are causing health problems for people across the country. We're going to continue to fight to bring down inflation and give people a break.
Thank you, President Biden.
Yo,
President Trump, you now
so
have 2 minutes for your closing statement.
Fried, bro.
Like so many politicians, this man is just a complainer. He said, we want to do this, we want to do that, we want to get rid of this tax, that tax.
Look at his lips.
But he doesn't do anything. He doesn't do. All he does is make our country unsafe by allowing millions and millions of people to pour in. Our military doesn't respect him. We looked like fools in Afghanistan. We didn't stop Israel. It was such a horrible thing that would have never happened. It should have never happened. Iran was broke. Anybody that did business with Iran, including China, they couldn't do business with the United States. They all passed. Iran was broke. They had no money for Hamas or Hezbollah, for terror, no money whatsoever. Again, Ukraine should have never happened. He talks about all this stuff, but he didn't do it. For 3.5 years, we're living in hell. We have the Palestinians and we have everybody else rioting all over the place. You talk about Charlottesville. This is 100 times Charlottesville, 1,000 times. The whole country is exploding because of you, because they don't respect you and they have to respect their president and they don't respect you throughout the world. What we did was incredible. We rebuilt the military. We got the largest tax cut in history, the largest regulation cut in history. The reason he's got jobs is because I cut the regulations that gave jobs, but he's putting a lot of those regulations back on. All of the things that we've done, nobody's ever never seen anything like, even from a medical standpoint, right to try, where we can try space-age materials instead of going to Asia or going to Europe and trying to get when you're terminally ill. Now you can go and you can get something. You sign a document. They've been trying to get it for 42 years. But you know what we did for the military was incredible. Choice for our soldiers, where our soldiers, instead of waiting for 3 months to see a doctor, can go out and get themselves fixed up and readied up and take care of themselves and their living. And that's why I had the highest approval rating in the history of the VA. So all of these things, we're in a failing nation, but it's not going to be failing anymore. We're going to make it great again.
Thank you, former President Trump, President Biden. Stay with us because we have full analysis of this debate.
Oh, no.
Anderson Cooper and Aaron Burnett starts now.
There ain't no analysis, bro. This shit was ass.
Is it going to get cute like the score?
Nah, what do you mean the score?
Is it people? Yes, bro.
Absolutely is not a fucking stud. He did not show up tonight.
There were mock, bro. They were leaking to the Wall Street Journal that he has a cold.
Yeah, I did. Oh. That's great. That definitely fixes it.
Yeah, thanks for telling us now.
Yeah, that definitely doesn't look like you were trying to desperately do PR as a last ditch effort.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, gang.
Certainly.
Biden got an FF. Just FF, gang. Like, just FF. You too old for this shit, right now. Like, you too, like his body, like, just FF, gang. FF, FF at five, FF at half, bro. Just GG's, bro.
FF at half, bro.
Just FF at half. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
But it's like, I don't even.
Like, chat, we're doomed. We're doomed, bro. We're doomed. I ain't gonna lie, bro.
Are you going IRL the front lines? Shut the fuck up.
Joe Biden was 26 in 1969. That nigga was my age.
But, bro, look, can we just keep in mind, like, I agree, old as fuck. Trump is only 3 years younger than that nigga, bro. Like,
the niggas had a million. God! Honestly, it should have been higher. Chat, this is our nation's fucking debate, gay. What do you mean, view body? Bro, CNN isn't viewbody the presidential election.
That's just playing
it
like on HBO.
Yeah, bro, no. A nigga in my comment said YouTube CNN is view botting the live stream. bro.
CNN got fucking 50 million people watching on actual TV.
Neon bots. Who fucked up like streaming bot culture, bro? Like, who was the one that just fucked everything up, bro? Nigga just called CNN view.
Bro, nigga just said Trump clip farming, bro. Are we serious, bro?
No. Trump is the OG clip farmer, bro. That nigga is a clip farm demon.
Bro.
Demon. And he tough at it, too. He him at it, bro. But, Wabe go eat dick.
It's about that time.
Chat, it's about that time. Ah-ha. Ah-ha. Wait, y'all like the beard? Should I cut it? I was gonna cut it before tomorrow.
First of all, everything you need to know is in our Discord DMs.
I was gonna cut it before tomorrow. Tasha, it's 2 months. Two months growth type.
I don't think that was very nice.
Wabe, we have a sponsor, dude. Get the fuck out of here.
But that was mean. Like you could have said, like I was finna slide anyway. But like nigga said,
shut up.
Ch- Chad, what if I was looking down at you like this? Would you kiss me back?
Okay, a couple prerequisites.